mismo heaven and earth para wala. Kapagka mahal naman nila yung ibigin nila. And one of the things of faith there was then asked that yung simula ang patatalik na dalit sa kanya. Kapagkat yung mga may kasalanan, yung mga may own issues, binigyan niya ng warning. Go abroad and don't let him come back. Go abroad and don't let him come back. If you stay, you'll handle my business. Tapos doon lang yung panahon na kapagpupunta kami lahat kami ng Arbito. Kasi yung mga pari niya lagi na pwede na ka-aspect yung museum. But we thank you very much because the one who was staying in the Baguio in comparison with the one staying and taking charge of the cathedral or the parishes in subdivisions and big subdivisions, they will be receiving the same thing. They will be receiving the same thing. No more, no less. No more, no less. And the bishop was always having any connection with them every month. They liked him so much. So whenever he changes them into other assignments, it's so easy. It's not obedience always a compromise between what I wish and what the superior asks. Might one not bargain for a certain limited autonomy? The idea is that fraternity asks of us all that we are. So no bargaining. No bargaining. I was told by my classmate, a Spanish Dominican. He said, kapag ikaw, ang Chinese sa university, pero ka-alay siya na buwi, sabi niya, kapag ikaw binigyan ng assignment, sundin mo agad. Kahit na ayaw mo, huwag kang nakapag-bargain. Sabi ko, bakit? Kasi pag ikaw nahirapan, duty pa ako ng superior mo ng kagaling. Rather than ikaw humiliate. It was a strategy. It was a strategy. But the thing that is that there should be no bargaining. There should not even be a condition. It was always all or nothing. Obedience is ordered towards caritas, an expression of love. We don't love just it must be wholehearted. Give everything. Must be so total something. Huwag kang magdala natin dito additional. There will inevitably be a tension between the process of dialogue, the search for consensus, the moment of handing one set of obedience to the hands of the grandad and the superior. Nevertheless, it is a fruitful tension. And an example natin dito is yung pag-medal yan, friction, it can either break or smoothen the stone. If it's going to break the stone, then that's sad, and that is not what we want. So sabi nila, bakit hindi na lang ganito ang project? There is a tension, but the tension brings about something good, something wonderful, as siguro, kapag may memorial, kapag aking may sang na maganda. So the three things there is that obedience is good to belong to the Father, to visit to be united, self-giving, and not bargaining. The wholehearted gift of one's life to the brethren and superiors is more than just the necessary flexibility of an organization. Kasi pag hindi nangyari ito, sisira ang transition mode. On the night he was betrayed by Jesus, when his life was doomed to failure, Jesus took bread, so it came to his disciples and said, this is my body, and I give it to you. Face to his faith, for it was necessary that the Son of Man be handed over. He made a supreme gesture of liberty, giving his life away. The vow of obedience, when a brother places his life in the hands of the superior, is actually synonymous to a Eucharistic gesture of man's liberty. Si Kristo, makasalanan tayo. May mga kasalanan tayo na hindi na natin ang salis. And yet, whenever he celebrates the Mass, he gives himself to us. He lets us touch him. And when we call him, he comes. That is actually the idea. This is my marriage I give to you. It's thus that we give ourselves to the mission of the Church. So the brother gives his life into the hands of the superior. This implies superiors under a force public obligation. The superior must have the courage that the brother is capable of doing wonderful things more than the doctor will ever imagine. I know in 19, it could not happen. Dami lang din, kapag pinadala sa mission sa amin, yun yung mga tao, either may problema, o hindi ko pwede sa school. Yun lang talaga yun. So, mahina. Mahina. Yun dami na naman. Tapos bigyan nagbago yung aming pananaw. Bigyan ang makapagala na doon yung dami na yung dementia, yung buong namin na mayroon ng doctorate. Nabago yung pananaw na yun. Kasi naniniwala na yung dating supposed to be para sa mission, hindi pagkasa pa, may pagkasa na makakontribute ng marami. Kahit sa school, na wala siyang tablet. Kahit sa formation, na parang hindi rin ang buhay niya. The superior, the provincial, our prior, is have a huge part to believe that this person can give us something that he has never given before, that he can become better than before. If God's providence has prepared his brother for his work, then we too must trust in God's providence for our needs. Nakapag-alit. Lumpas na maraming taon. Lumpas na maraming pagsuko. At binasbasan ng mga superior at ng obispo. Maniwala tayo. Maniwala tayo. Nakapag-alit. Nothing new can ever be born unless you dare to give us what has been provided to have value material that which will turn out to be a failure. Why? Because none from among us really can know in advance. Kaya na yung faith na makalakas dapat. The pressure of our society is that once you have an idea that life will go somewhere, has to be prepared, and we don't have to prepare. To give one's life to the preaching of the gospel is to renounce that pressure that wherever we go, that is to be in the world. We are people who have no career, no prospect. This is the freedom. So obedience actually gives us freedom rather than to give up our personal freedom. We are most free when we obey. This is the gift of the Lord, as was the resurrection after the failure of the cross. A true gift is of this nature a surprise. On the mountain of the Transfiguration, Peter was fascinated by the vision of the glory that he has seen. Sabi niya, let's build Bethlehem and stay here. He resists the call of Jesus to walk on the way to Jerusalem, where he must suffer and die. He fails to see that it is in the death, on the cross, that the glory will be revealed. That's the surprise. We are warned not to remain fascinated by the glory of our past. Parang may kong ginawa doon eh. Siguro hindi ako kakandali. Kaya kailangan ako ng lugar na ito eh. Ang mga tao nito eh. So dapat dito na lang ako. Tapos kung sa hindi ko ata. There's something. Like Peter, we may be hypnotized and paralyzed and resist the invitation to get up and walk, to share death and resurrection. Every organization must face death and every generation. But, sabi nga, there is this sterile death. Those who remain stuck on the mountain transfiguration when the Lord has left. And there is the virgin death of those who are there to take the road and travel with him to the mountain, which he means the resurrection. Obedience to belong to the Father, to listen to be united, and it is a total self-denial. Your obedience.